For the user, the first step is to go to the VIS website. The user enters the CAPTCHA, enters their mobile number, and clicks on verify. So now an OTP is triggered to this mobile number. The user enters the OTP, the second CAPTCHA, and clicks on login. On successful login, below there is a banner which tells that as a beneficiary, I can register for Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. If I'm a senior citizen above the age of 70 years or more, so the user can click here to enroll, enter their Aadhaar number and the CAPTCHA again. When the user clicks on search, it will show the result that this Aadhaar number does not exist in the existing database. So the user can click here for fresh enrollment of the scheme. In the next page, the user triggers an OTP for the Aadhaar number shown on screen. First, the user has to agree to the consent language where they provide consent that their Aadhaar can be used for creation of an ABHR number, which is Ayushman Bharat Health Account, on successful enrollment. On providing the consent and clicking on allow, two OTPs are triggered. The first OTP is to the Aadhaar linked mobile number and the second OTP to the mobile number. After the successful verification of the OTP, this is the declaration screen where it shows that the authentication is successful and the beneficiary is eligible for the Ayushman Bharat 70 years or more scheme. So the user can provide information if they are a beneficiary of any of the existing government schemes or click none of the above. If the name of the scheme is not listed, the user can self-declare. If they choose any other scheme, they have to forego the benefits. So, the user can click on none of the above and proceed ahead. eKYC is successfully completed. The user can view that the eKYC details have already been fetched along with all the relevant details. So the beneficiary will capture a photo here and click on proceed. The next step is to fill the father correspondence address. The user will first enter the Sautka, the mobile number. It will again trigger an OTP which needs to be verified. The user selects the category. The user enters the PIN code, select the district, so all mandatory information marked are filled. Here, the user has to declare all their family member details, regardless of their age. So this will ensure that all the family member details are captured. The user can enter the relationship with the primary member, name, gender, date of birth, and the Aadhaar number. This is verified against the details present in Aadhaar. For this video, the user will skip this step. The user will declare that they do not have any other family member, and the user will also certify that the details of my family member are true to the best of his knowledge and clicks on submit. So clicks on submit. The system shows the information that the enrollment process is completed. After 15 minutes, the card for senior citizens will be ready and it can be downloaded.